the service announcement brought to you by the Million Dollar Man, Ted Biasi, and Irwin R. Steister.
This is so disgusting to me. I mean, how revolting. Nobody wears clip-on suspenders anymore. Did you see those?
Yeah. What's this grip map stuff?
No,
Irwin R. Steister, ladies and gentlemen. Well, that'll make taxpayers, cheaters that is, pay. Under normal circumstances, he will make his opponent pay in a different regard.
No question, he handles a lot of money. He is the accountant for the million-dollar team. And the WWF Survivor Series handles all their assets, and they are quite numerous.
Yes, indeed, Mike Bell, hoping to pull off an upset. Who knows, anything can happen in the World Wrestling Federation, that's for sure. And I believe Irwin has his hands on the microphone.
I've said it before, and I'll say it again. Nobody will rest in peace until you've paid all your taxes.
Isn't that nice where he holds the microphone for Ted DiBiase to laugh?
Yeah, oh, how sweet. Teamwork, you know, they were partners for so long. I guess they don't forget. There they are, future accountants of America.
Yeah, I would suggest that The Undertaker has been listening intently to the comments of Irwin R. Scheifer a little bit, and who has taken an unkindly view as to IRS's remarks.
Somebody you would not want to have on your back, though.
What's this now? Yeah, sure, there was a hair pull. Why is it when people like Irwin are showing up, all of a sudden he's like, we go to this defensive mechanism type thing. Look at this, knocking back up now. Hey, nice takedown there by Irwin. He has a thing with his hair.
See?
How did you know that?
You don't spit in the wind, you don't pull on Superman's cape, and you don't mess with IRS's hair.
What about his tie?
Now, the tie doesn't mind, but the hair.
Mike Bell to the far side with authority. Take nothing away from the wrestling skill of Irwin R. Scheister. You may not like him, and not too many people do, but when it comes to technique, this man is right up there with the very, very best of them. Ooh, with an elbow.
I think he needs a haircut.
Irwin R. Scheister does not like his profession, I would suggest. He doesn't even like his own name.
There's class and there's no class. You people have no class at all.
Wait a minute, Ted DiBiase talking about class?
Yep.
He only went to 10th grade.
Ooh. And a clothesline.
Paid off the principal so he could graduate. Then he went to college, graduated magna cum money.
Whoa, look at that! A three count! Yeah. Irwin R. Scheister, ladies and gentlemen, victorious on his way to the Survivor Series. We talked about his technique earlier on. That, of course, related to the technique of the one and only World Wrestling Federation champion, the Hitman Bret Hart, as well as that of his opponent, Bob Backlund. Let's go back now, ladies and gentlemen, the date, December 26, 1983. Bob Backlund found himself in Madison Square Garden after approximate six-year reign as WWF champion. From there, a submission hold applied. Bob Backlund claimed he never gave up. Backlund claimed he never said, I quit. Nonetheless, his manager, Arnold Skold, in the corner, threw in the towel nonetheless and ended the reign of Bob Backlund as the World Wrestling Federation champion.
And then for the next 10 years, Bob Backlund would replay this night over and over again in his head. He would see it in his eyes, the camel clutch being locked in, and see Arnold Skolin going in the towel. He would never, ever forget it.
He never forgave either, and then finally it happened for him. After a 10-year absence, ladies and gentlemen, finally happened the dream come true. Bob Backlund at his shop. He would become WWF champion again. He would face the current title holder, Bret Hart. Bob Backlund against the Hitman. When Bret Hart defeated Bob, now get from there! A change, Bob Backlund! Bob Backlund would simplify everything you would want in a WWF champion. Snapped at that moment!
He snapped! He's twisted! He lost total control! 10 years of frustration came out at once, and Bob Backlund would not let go. To this day, he refuses to believe that he is not the WWF champion. He claims, hey, everybody else is wrong. I never gave up. Arnold Skolin threw in that towel.
He would challenge anyone. Bob Backlund, ladies and gentlemen, who now espouses his views, claiming to be better than anyone else. His values far superior to anyone else. There, he applied in a demonstration of cross-faced chicken wing. gentlemen, the 1-2-3 kid just might be next. Wrexham tried last Monday night unsuccessfully. However, this Monday night, the matchup is made one-on-one. It's Bob Backlund against the 1-2-3 kid. And of course, all this leads to Thanksgiving Eve. Oh. 19, ladies and gentlemen. 83, Bob Backlund, champion once again.
You know, there's a lot of people that are really concerned about this match with you, Bob Backlund. Bob Backlund, a great technical wrestler, a great champion in his time. But you know what, Bob Backlund? I look forward to this match. I'm used to all kinds of matches. And there's a lot of guys that'll stoop to any level to be the champion. But I don't see that in you, Bob. I don't see that in you at all. You know what I see in you, Bob? I don't know about you being the old generation so much as maybe being from the lost generation. Because I think you've lost your mind, Bob. I don't think you're playing with a full deck. You've lost all your marbles and you're living in some kind of a dream world. Technical wrestling? I do technical wrestling. I do it better than anybody in the entire planet. And you know what, Bob Backlund? I got the British Bulldog in my corner. This match is a submission match. The cross-wing, chicken wing, or whatever it is, against the sharpshooter, Bob Backlund, I will never, ever submit. And the British Bulldog, what are you going to do with that towel?
This towel is not leaving the hands of the British Bulldog.
See you in the Survivor Series, Bob.